Have you ever read a book and you felt less alone in the world? Have you ever read a book and you felt more worthy of love as you were and more hopeful, like you could get your happily ever after as well? Well, that's how I felt when I first read the first in the series of The Brown Sisters by Talia Hibbert. Get a Life, Chloe Brown. Today, we're going to talk about trusting yourself as a writer. We're going to talk about how romance is an amazing genre and absolutely doesn't deserve the scorn it gets, is actually one of the best ways to like make a living and find joy in life. And we're going to talk about building a scaffolding around a genre, how a genre, writing within a genre, can really help you build up and normalize what might be considered otherness.
I'm Talia Hibbert, as you said. I'm a writer of what I like to call sexy, diverse romance, and I just really love love stories and anything that makes people feel warm and fuzzy inside and gets them wriggling around in their chair with excitement. I hope I'm not the only one who does that.
No, you're not.
And I also, you know, especially want to create that feeling for marginalized people who maybe don't get it as much as we deserve. So, you know, adding to the body of work that kind of uplifts people like me and other people on the margins is something that I really enjoy. Because when you have that kind of scaffolding, you know, that's how you climb to ridiculous heights. Mm-hmm. You can't do new and wild things and do them, I think, in a compelling way that really hits a note with most people unless you've got that kind of tried and true scaffolding that exists, because we've all had those beats bred into us, right? Mm-hmm. Like when they talk about stories that are really similar from culture to culture, even in cultures that technically have different ways of storytelling, it's because certain emotional beats hit all of us in the same way, because we all experience these emotions. And romance is built so heavily on beats and tropes that are tightly linked with emotion. So yeah, I think that is why it's so easy and so fun to widen what normality means when you're writing romance, because you have like these familiar tropes, and that framework allows you to introduce what to some people might be unfamiliar, and also allows you to kind of validate the people who know it's normal but are maybe told that it's not normal, and they get to see themselves in that trope and be like, hey, yeah, I'm me and they're them and we're the same, because, you know, we count.
I just want to know, why do you think that we think of romance as trashy or guilty, or we have these ideas of it being lesser than, when in reality it's one of the bigger parts of the publishing industry?
It's misogyny. That's all it is. It's so beautifully simple. Misogyny.
Beautifully simple. Yeah.
You know, I know that obviously when we say misogyny as well, we mostly think of women, but like all marginalized genders, I think, are the ones who are being kind of blanket put down when people talk about quote unquote women's things, which doesn't really exist, but you know, and that's, so it's not just misogyny, it's all the other kind of intersected gender stuff. So my first two books that I self-published, they were like a novelette and then a novella, and it was very much needing to prove to myself that I could finish something and that I could publish something, and neither of them ever made very much money, which was fine. I kind of needed to do it to encourage myself, and I was so happy with them and so proud of them, but then as I grew more confident and I was able to write more and more and really settle into who I wanted to be as a writer and what I wanted to create, I realized that those early books where I was finding my feet just didn't fit with my work as a whole, so I just got rid of them. I took them down from everywhere.
Well, thank you so much for coming on and sharing such amazing wisdom. And I'm a huge fan of the whole Brown Sisters books. And I'm super excited that Act Your Age, Eve Brown, is coming out today, the day that this podcast airs. So everybody go get a copy. If you haven't read all three, just go buy all three. Trust me, you're just going to want to devour one after another after another. They are really, really beautifully written books. And they'll make y'all squirmy in your seat too, which is very exciting. Thank you again for coming on here. It's been amazing chatting with you.
Thank you so much for having me. I've had a great time.